Hello, students and friends of the HorrorTube/BookTube community. It is I, Coach Stroud, coming at you live with another amazing and stupendous episode of Coach Stroud's What to Read While Quarantined. In this episode, I'm going to be talking to you about Keelan Patrick Burke's The House on Abigail Lane. Now, first and foremost, let me say that I've read two books by Keelan Patrick Burke, this one and another one called Sour Candy. And Sour Candy was absolutely amazing. Loved every second of it. Completely freaked me out. Good, scary book. So for Christmas, my wife asked me what kind of books would I like. I said, I would like a couple of Keelan Patrick Burke books. And she picked me up a few of them, this being one of them. Now, if I could tell you right now, it seems to be that some of his stories are kind of short, and I like this. I like it because I can get invested into a story, I can feel a certain way about characters, and I can, you know, move on, move quickly, and feel accomplished very, very quickly. As I say quickly another time. But that being said, this book's a little bit different. As for a main character, they're really... really isn't one, unless you want to count the house on Abigail Lane. This house is just some random house that was built, and there's no direct reason, rhyme or reason for why things happen or why things strange go on there. It's just that many people have had experiences there that have been, some of them been unpleasant, some of them have resulted in death, some of them have resulted in showing up naked outside the house. With a group of other people that you're kind of unsure of how they got there naked outside the house. It's very interesting. The only drawback I have to this book is that I felt like it kind of read like a better, well-written Wikipedia article. It does pull quotes and stuff from other books and stories that are out there about the house on Abigail Lane. Of course, all fictional. But the overall concept of the book is really, really interesting and one that I'm completely a fan of and I think more people should try out. So I'm going to read the back to you really quick. And if it's something you might enjoy, I would highly suggest you pick it up. I think it sells on Amazon for like $7 or $8. That's a great deal. All right. From outside, it looks like an ordinary American home. But since its construction in 1956, people have vanished as soon as they go upstairs, the only clues, the things that they leave behind. A wedding ring, a phone, an eye. In its 60-year history, a record number of strange events have been attributed to the house. From the neighbors walking up to find themselves standing in the yard outside, from the neighbors waking up, to find themselves standing in the yard outside, to the grieving man who vanished before the police officer's eyes, the animals gathering in the yard as if summoned, the people who speak in reverse, the lights and sounds, the music, the grass dying overnight, and the 10-foot clown on the second floor. And as long as there are mysteries, people will be compelled to solve them. Here, then, is the most comprehensive account of the Abigail House phenomenon, the result of 60 years of eyewitness accounts, news reports, scientific research, and parapsychological investigations, all in an attempt to decode the enduring mystery that is the house on Abigail Lane. So again, it basically reads like that. Like it reads like a report that's been compiled of all these different references and articles. Overall, good read. I enjoyed it very much and I highly would recommend it. It was very creepy, but I will let you know right now, if you're someone who needs like endings that are complete, this is one you're going to need to stay away from. This one does not really have a direct ending by any means. And again, like I said, there are no real main characters unless you count the house. And I don't even think I would count the house as a main character. Still not even enough information on it to glorify a main character spot. But that being said, but I do want to point out right here, if you haven't noticed, this sunflower that's on the cover It's an eyeball. It's just a neat little detail that's thrown into the cover there. Keelan Patrick Burke, The House on Abigail Lane. He does all of his covers. This is another beauty. Give it a look. Give it a check. Until next time, people, I look forward to seeing you and talking to you soon. Deuces, we're out.